Welcome to Zapier, the best way to transform your work experience. Every day, team leaders like you and I have to manage multiple people. With that comes lots of emails, file shares, Slack messages, and more. In order to manage all of this, you use a lot of time each day, until now. Zapier is a program and internet plugin that team leaders can use to manage their teams and automate workflows. With over 3,000 app integrations, customizable built-in actions, and extendable workflows, managing a team has never been easier. In this video, we're going to give you a brief walkthrough of the platform, as well as an example of how you can easily manage your team using Zapier. When you first start using Zapier, there's a free option, up to a certain number of Zaps. Zaps refer to the customizable actions you've created to help manage your team automatically. This could be anything from connecting Gmail and Dropbox in order to have your email files saved automatically to Dropbox, or it could be connecting Slack and YouTube so that anytime you post a new video, your team can be automatically notified. As you begin using Zapier more, the app will begin showing you suggested Zaps, customized by your current work patterns. This helps automate your projects even more. As mentioned earlier, there are 3,000 app integrations. If you don't see the app you're looking for on the homepage, you can search for it. Now I'm going to show you how to set up a personalized Zap. First, click on the orange Make a Zap button in the top right corner. Next, you're going to choose your trigger app. Let's use Trello as our trigger app. What this means is if the trigger is a new Trello card being added, then each time a new Trello card is added, the Zap will be triggered to complete your desired action. To start this process, click on Trello in the app selection. When you click on Trello, there will be multiple trigger options for you to choose from. You can choose the app to be triggered when a new card is added, if there's new activity, if a new label is put on a card, if a card is archived, and even more. It's all customizable to meet your needs. For this, let's choose when a card is added. Once you connect your Trello account and follow the steps, you'll need to choose the Action app. This way, when Trello is triggered, another app is set up to do something else. Let's choose Slack as our Action app. By choosing Slack as your action app, when a new card is added into Trello, Slack is set to perform the action you want. In my job, it's helpful for Slack to notify my freelance team when a new card is added to Trello. So let's set Slack to send a channel message as the action. When going through the steps, choose the channel or channels you want to have notified. From here, you can choose to have a personalized message sent to your team each time, to have the message come from Slackbot rather than you, and more. And this is all done through Zapier. It's just that easy. The great thing about Zapier is that it's affordable. Zapier is free, so for smaller teams, this can work perfectly. However, you are limited to the number of tasks you can set and the number of Zaps you can use each month. If your team uses more Zaps per month than the free version allows, there are a few affordable monthly plans that you can check out on their website. Now, why is FreeUp telling you about Zapier? Well, that's because Zapier makes managing your freelance team a breeze. After using FreeUp to find your team, you can use Zapier to automate all of your processes with that team. There are a ton of integrations out there. There's so much you can do with Zapier, and you can completely customize each Zap to fit your needs. Stop wasting time each morning sending emails, downloading files, updating your team members on small tasks. You could have just used Zapier. If you're interested in hiring a freelancer for any of your tasks, or if you need someone to specifically set up Zaps, we've got you covered. Check us out at freeup.net.